thanks so much for tuning into today's video. If you're new to this channel, my name is Jafrin. I'm a makeup, fashion, lifestyle fanatic. I like to post a lot of different makeup tutorials, collection videos, outfit ideas, all that jazz. So if you're interested in that, then this is the channel for you. I wanted to start off this video by just thanking everyone for all the love and support that you've been showing me. I've been really surprised by all the views that I've been getting on my luxury bag collection videos. I really appreciate it. You guys have been so interactive with me, leaving comments here and there, and I'm so grateful. I did want to mention that I'm not an expert in luxury goods. It's just something that I was into as I sort of moved from makeup into fashion. And so now I just want to talk about, the things that I like and my experiences with all of that. But my main passion is makeup. So if you guys can check out my makeup videos, that would be great. Because that's my first passion. I'm still going to be doing a lot of luxury designer goods videos, a lot of fashion videos. I have so many outfit videos coming out because I spent so much money recently on a lot of fall fashion, so you have that coming for you guys. But just wanted to let you guys know, check them out. It really means a lot to me. If you're not subscribed to this channel, please subscribe. And if you like whatever types of videos you like, just give it a thumbs up so that I know what to do going forward. But without further ado, let's get right to it. If you couldn't figure out by the title of this video, it's been a highly requested one. It's my Chanel bag collection video. And I really am excited to do this because my Chanel bags are probably one of my favorite category of bags in my collection. I have 6 bags. I'm going to be showing you guys 5 today because my 6th bag is actually not here. It's in my parents' house. And I feel like I want to do its own video because that's how special that bag is to me. So I'm going to be showing you guys 5 bags today, and I just wanted to mention that these bags, I think 4 out of 5 of them I purchased on the pre-loved market. Only one of them I bought brand new. So if you are interested in finding this particular piece, you might have to look in the pre-loved market because that's how I found them. I don't know if Chanel carries certain styles still. I know they have thousands and thousands of unique styles and limited edition pieces, but I would check the pre-loved market first. And also, because Chanel has been hiking up their prices recently, I know they did a price increase earlier this year, right, when the pandemic hit, so I was a little discouraged by that. And I've heard, I don't know if it's true, but I've heard that they're going to be doing another price increase. And so Chanel bags are already pretty expensive compared to other luxury brands, and it's some of the items are getting close to Birkin prices. So I feel like if you are in the market for a Chanel bag, just do your research, try to look in the pre-loved market because you can find some really amazing pieces there. But if not, budget wisely. So without further ado, let's get started on the first bag. So the first bag I have for you guys is this Chanel medium size LeBoy bag in the lambskin leather and gold hardware. And it's the quilted design as well because Chanel LeBoy has different designs on the front of their bag. I purchased this bag. This is the only bag that I purchased brand new. And the reason for that is because it was my first purchase. I purchased this when my wardrobe was a lot more casual than it is now, and I thought that the LeBoy style would be the perfect, I guess, accessory to all of my outfits. And, now that I look at it, it's still one of my favorite bags, but I just don't wear it as often because I feel like my wardrobe has been a lot more classic, elegant. And this bag just, doesn't seem to go with everything. I can still wear it with a lot of my ethnic wear. I'm Bengali, so I do wear saris, salwar kameezes to events, and I feel like this bag goes great with it. It's a very structured bag, so I love that because you don't have to worry about it kind of collapsing into itself. It's a medium-sized bag, and it fits literally all of my stuff. The only thing I can't really put in here is a water bottle. I mean, I could put a water bottle in here and then just like my wallet, keys, and my phone. It'll fit. But I just love it for that reason. It fits a lot of stuff. The hardware is beautiful. I know Chanel has different types of hardware. This is the shinier gold. There's like a more brassy gold out there, but it's just, you know, it's a beautiful bag and it goes with all of my stuff. Let me just show you the rest of the strap. It has a clasp opening over here, and the strap is half chain and half leather. So it's chain, and then there's leather up here. There are embellishments on the leather as well, so you can, I guess you can change how long it is, but I don't really mess with the strap. I like to wear this on my shoulder like this. I feel like it looks great. It doesn't hit my underarm. I don't have to worry about my arm being all out there. And you can wear crossbody too, but I feel like this medium size is a little too big for my frame. And so I only like to wear it really on my shoulder or on the crook of my arm. But it's a beautiful bag. And I feel like, you know, because I don't wear it as much, it might be one that I resell. I'm thinking about reselling it just so that I can add other pieces to my collection. But yeah, it's the first purchase I've made with Chanel, and I don't regret it. I got a lot of use out of it. I will say that the lambskin leather is a lot harder to care for than the caviar leather. The caviar leather is more grained, so if you have a scratch, like I can already see a scratch here and there on my bag, and only I can see it because I know where it is, but lambskin scratches pretty easily if you're not careful with it. So that's one thing I would keep in mind when purchasing any designer bag. You know, lambskin leather, smooth leather is always going to show blemishes a lot more. So that's something I would consider. But regarding like the quality of the bag, for all the years that I've had it, it hasn't, you know, collapsed into itself, and it still looks pretty brand new. There are pretty, you know, a few scratches on the clasp right here, but it doesn't really bother me, and I don't think it would bother anybody if they decided to resell it, because it's still a beautiful bag and it looks brand new to this day. So yeah, this is the Chanel Le Boy in the medium size in the lambskin quilted leather and gold hardware. The next bag in my collection is the Chanel Le Boy in the small size, in the caviar leather with the chevron design and ruthenium hardware. I am absolutely in love with this bag. Actually, in my top 5 luxury handbag videos, I was debating whether to include this Chanel or the mini rectangular that I featured in that video. And honestly, I wear these bags like equal amounts. After purchasing that Le Boy, I was still into the Le Boy design. I actually, around that time, hated the way the classic Chanel bags looked. I know, crazy, because now I have 3 of them, but I was still into this style, and I felt like because I had something gold, I wanted to get something that I could wear with other jewelry, silver jewelry, I guess. And you know, I wanted to explore different styles, different leathers, and so I happened to find this one on the pre-loved market, and I'm absolutely obsessed. It's a smaller bag, so I wear it when I'm going to dinner, if I'm going on a night out. It fits all of my stuff. It actually does fit my phone, my hand cream, my wallet. It's such a cute bag, and you know, just like the other Le Boy, it still held its structure. I feel like this one, I've done a lot more damage to it, you know, because sometimes I go on a night out and I come home at like 3 a.m. and it's like, oh, is my bag okay? But it's okay because it's caviar leather and it shows less, the damages, the blemishes. I don't notice anything crazy on it now, but there is a little bit of scratching on the hardware, but that's okay because the ruthenium hardware is kind of like a gunmetal, so it's made to look, you know, a little more rough, a little rustic. And I just love the chevron design. I think compared to the quilted, it looks a lot more edgy. I like to wear this with casual outfits, but I can wear it with a more elegant classic like work look as well. It'll look perfect with that. The strap is similar to the other Le Boy strap. It has the chain, and the leather on the top. This is also caviar leather, and then the embellishments right here. And this one you can wear on the shoulder as well, and I have, But I like to wear this one more on the crossbody style because it looks perfect. Doesn't look too heavy. I'm petite and it looks perfectly fine with my frame. And it's just a really all-around great bag. This is the Chanel Le Boy in the small size, chevron caviar leather with the ruthenium hardware. Okay, now the next bag you've already seen. I featured it in my top 5 luxury bags 2020 video. If you haven't seen that video, check it out because it does a good representation of the bags that I love up until now. I think I might do one. I mean, the year's almost over and I do have a few pieces that I love now more than I did earlier in the year. So I'll do a separate video of my updated top 5 bags, but this is one that I featured in that video. And this is the Chanel Mini Rectangular in the lambskin leather and silver hardware. I'm not going to talk too much about this because I did talk about it already, but this is probably my favorite Chanel bag out of all of them. The Le Boy Small is a close second, but I love this because it is so classic. It's a beautiful classic style. It's a mini bag, which I love. I'm obsessed with mini bags because I don't like to carry a lot of things on the go. I'm a small girl. Smaller bags just look better on me and I get tired of carrying all my junk. So I just love this because it fits everything. It's not as hard and sturdy as the Le Boy, but it still holds its structure. Like if I squeeze it, it'll come back. I don't have to worry about it collapsing into itself. And it has such a pillowy, soft feel to it. I do have to be a little more careful when using this bag because it is the lambskin leather. I feel like, you know, I've had a few blemishes and damages on it, but I can fix them really easy. You can take them to a bag repair shop, go to someone you trust, do your research because you don't want to take your thousands and thousands of dollars and throw it in the drain by taking it to someone who doesn't know how to take care of these bags. But yeah, I you know, make sure to take care of it. It's a classic style. I love the strap. That's the main reason why I decided to purchase the Chanel Classic Style, because once my wardrobe kind of upgraded into a more elegant, classic work look, I decided that this is the most flattering type of bag for that wardrobe. The strap is just a beautiful leather intertwined with the metal. Such a classic look. If anybody sees it, they'll know you're wearing a Chanel. This bag, I think, is only crossbody. Haven't figured out a way to wear it any other way. I'm sure, you know, somebody out there has come up with a way, but I only wear it crossbody, and you know, you don't really need anything else to complete your look because this strap is just so amazing. It adds such a nice sparkle and it's great detail. So again, if you're thinking about purchasing a Chanel, I do recommend getting a classic style because it's timeless. You won't ever have to worry about it being out of trend. And it's beautiful, goes with everything. So this is the Chanel Mini Rectangular in the lambskin leather and silver hardware. All right, we have 3 out of the 5 bags done. Now these next two pieces are pieces that I did not intend on purchasing. They were just bags that I happened to come across on the pre-loved market, and when I saw it, I just fell in love. As you know, my wardrobe is very neutral, and I don't add a lot of color. Even in my bag collection, I would say 45 to 50% of my bags are black. But when I saw these two Chanel bags, I just fell in love. They were so amazing, and I didn't know if I would find them again because I thought that that color combination was pretty rare. So let's get right into it. The first bag I am going to show you is the Chanel Classic in the medium size in this beautiful gray caviar leather with silver hardware. Just look at how beautiful this is. It's one of my favorite bags in my collection. I feel like I say that about all my bags, but it's honestly a one-of-a-kind bag. I don't have a lot of gray in my collection. I only have about 2 other larger bags that are gray and different tones of gray as well, but this one is such a muted, you know, light neutral gray, a little more on the warm side as opposed to a cool gray, and it's just a beautiful bag. I love that it's caviar leather. because, again, same thing, like, I don't have to worry about scuffing it up. If I do, it won't show. I can already, when I received the bag, it was already a little, I would say worn. I did take it to my repair person, and they did clean it up a little bit. But honestly, because it's a gray bag, any sort of fading or damage won't show. Again, it's silver hardware down here. The way the Classic opens up is you just twist it here and then you can open up the flap. It has a double flap inside with a little zipper right here. There is another flap with the CC over here. And then there are two little buttons. This is where the main Classic goes. And then I guess you can hook this flap to this button. I don't really put anything in like these extra pockets. There's like a bunch of extra pockets. My phone doesn't even fit in this pocket, but like if I have a receipt or a card, I'll just put it in here. There's another flap little thing right here. And there's just a bunch of pockets within the bag as well. And I love the Classic style now because of the many different ways you can wear it. This bag compared to the Mini, you can wear on your shoulder and crossbody. So I love it. I love that it has that original strap look, the fabric intertwined with the metal, because again, I feel like it completes any outfit. It's just the perfect accessory. And so I love to wear it on my shoulder like this. I love to wear it on the crook of my arm or just carrying it like this. And you can wear it crossbody. I feel more comfortable wearing this bag crossbody than I do the Chanel Le Boy in the medium size because I feel like it doesn't stick out as much. But yeah. It's a beautiful color combination. You can wear it with anything. It's such a neutral color. And I feel like I probably will keep this in my collection for years and years to come because God knows if I'll ever find this again. So yeah, this is the Chanel Classic or double flap. I think it's the double flap in the medium size in gray caviar leather with silver hardware. All right, so the last bag in my collection is another Chanel Classic double flap in the medium size. And this time it's in the beige lambskin leather with gold hardware. I featured this bag in my summer outfits video, and out of the two medium-sized Chanel double flaps, I wear this one more just because I've been wearing a little more gold in my wardrobe recently, but I am just absolutely obsessed with this bag. This is another bag that I came across in the pre-loved market. I never thought I would find a color combination like this, but I did, and it goes with everything. It's such a timeless bag. Similar to the other gray bag, it has all the little flaps, and you know, the gold embellishment within the bag is just beautiful. But again, the main reason why I love it is for the strap. The strap is this beautiful beige and gold, and just completes any outfit for me, honestly. Like even this top right here, it's a champagne-ish beige, but this, I could still wear it. Like it'll still go, and it just, you know, completes everything. I love this bag. I love this color combination. I love wearing it in the summer mostly. I think the gray one I wear more in the fall, but it's beautiful. Even though it's lambskin, I haven't found any blemishes on it. You know, I've used it quite a few times, but you know, I like to check the bottom a lot because I do place my bag on tables. But yeah, it's a lot more soft than the other one, but it's still sturdy. And I feel like if you're going to purchase a Chanel bag, go for caviar leather first. But if you did go for lambskin leather, you won't be disappointed. It's still a beautiful bag. So yeah, this is the Chanel Classic double flap in the medium size, beige color, gold hardware. All right, guys, that is all. You've seen my Chanel bags, and I hope you like them. If you are interested in purchasing a Chanel bag, I suggest you do that as soon as you can, because like I mentioned, Chanel's prices are getting really high up there, close to Birkin's, and especially for the classic styles, I know that they run more than the Le Boy style. So if you're interested in that style, then go out there, do your research, try to find what you love before the next price increase, because it's gonna happen. I feel it's gonna happen. And the resale value for these bags is great. So if you feel like, you know, you're getting tired of one bag, you can really just look for another one and get most of your money back. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think. And if you can subscribe to this channel, like this video, give it a thumbs up. That would mean so much to me. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.